any question about meditation? First.
Yes.
When we start with the Om, I was actually doing my mantra at the same time. Is that okay? Or do you
have to do Om only?
You do
full
Om
concentration there. Oh,
okay. Okay. I didn't know what I have to do, yes or no.
You have to do mantra after that, when you stop.
Okay.
Because, yes?
No, maybe you should still ask me.
Objective is, that's why I give you the example of the ball of iron,
Sorry?
Iron ball.
Yes.
When put in fire, behaves like fire. It is not fire. In the same way, over chitta, because it is in the supreme consciousness seat, so it behaves like consciousness. It is not consciousness. Chitta behaves like consciousness, works like consciousness, as ball of iron when you see it is red, gives light, it can burn you also. But after a time, nothing is there. When it cools down, nothing is there. In the same way, chitta is without anything. It's not consciousness. The consciousness which we are holding, with which we are working in this world is just the shadow of that Supreme Self. And in that shadow, we think we are intelligent. We know everything. We know nothing. Actually, we know nothing.
I'm very confident
with that.
Even we don't know the light, even shadow we are not seeing of that. That's why I say, go in, stay in, so that you can see at least the shadow. With shadow you can follow the reality. You can see, whose shadow it is. We have to read that. That's why staying in is very important. And staying in will, what happens? You will start seeing inside out. When you start seeing inside, then you come someday see shadow. With shadow, then you will look at whose shadow it is, from where it has come. The next search will start. Then sometime you will go above chitta, and then you see the path from which that, light has come, because of which this shadow has been created. There then you expand. With expansion, then you see, I am, I know. I knew this previously also. Samprajñāt means, samprajñāt, prajñāt previously, jñāt, I knew it. Samprajñāt, completely I knew it previously also. That day you will, I knew it, I have forgotten it. In Gita also, Arjuna has said the same thing. Okay, what he says, Krishna, because of you, I attained the forgotten memory. Memory came to me. Smriti labhvat tat prasadat mehachut. Because of your grace, my memory, which I has come up. I remember now that I was this. Because I have forgotten my real form, so I was objecting that I will follow your orders, commands, Then he says, Krishe vachanam tam, whatever you will say now, I will do it. So, in the same way when you read there, and when you realize, In some pragya samadhi you will say, oh, I knew it previously. That's why sometimes in your, you know, memories you say, it seems that I've seen you somewhere.
Yeah.
Come like that. Mm-hmm. In the same way when you go there, you will say, oh, I knew this age of mine.
Oh, you've seen this before.
Yeah. Oh. So those coverings, they are false. But because we are living in that covering, we say it is all right. That's why scripture says, untruth though it is, but it looks like truth. That's why we are living this world. The day that truth is known, this existing world will vanish. Oh, no importance will be there. It's not there. It was only over false notion. Oh, this world is over. Everybody is over. What we are doing, that's right. Everything will be up. Then what? It's nothing. We were doing everything wrong.
We didn't know.
Yes. Then the day you know it is done, it is undone, you know. What you have done, that will be undone. And then real way of life, which is the objective of yoga darshana, through some pragya, that will come. Because that's why I say go in and become first one seer. Because you can know your real form when you know, read the next sutra, that is Tada drashtu swarupe avasthanam. Tada, meaning that state. Drashta, the seer, feels, realizes, this is my form. I am not nature. I am not like ball of, you know, iron. I am consciousness. Then he knows, I am alone, I am alone existing. Other things which I up to now believe, they are not existing actually. I gave them existence, and when that existence was because of ignorance, knowing the reality, their existence also goes away. So through yoga, you have to realize that. And when you see ball is like, you know, the same chitta. We said chitta is just to show you whatever comes in front of. Mm-hmm.
And that's how we see Sita.
Yes. And when you see chitta, chitta is clear, without any impression in it. Impression, the knowledge is because of that shadow of consciousness which you are believing we are. That fall notion will, you know, then fall out. That will go away and you will see the reality where peace is waiting for you, knowledge is waiting for you, love is waiting for you, pervasiveness is waiting for you, and a state of mind where nothing can affect you of the outer world, that is waiting for you. But you are not ready yet. You are not crying.
Yes, you're right.
Why you are not ready? Because you are not crying your best. Oh, because you stop in way. And this is up to you. Are with me, you are trying. What about the rest of the time? You are not doing it. So you have to try your best, you know. It must become, you know, part of your mind. Mind should remember, oh, I have to do this, I have to realize this, so that my actual form may come out of me. It is there in you. God is your friend. In Upanishad, there is an example, you know, Simba. They say, two birds are sitting on the branch of a tree. They are friends. And they are, you know, they are born together also. At one time, you know, at the same time they took birth. Like, you know, any woman who has two child, they do take time to grow, you know. There's a difference in their birth. But they were born together, they came into existence together. And they are friends. But you have not created friendness with that, you know, self yet. Your friendness is somewhere else. You are seeing friendness somewhere else. You are searching your friend somewhere else. You have to search that friend by staying inside, by seeing inside. The day you see your friends, things are set all right. And you know the way of life, which is the aim of yoga. Mm-hmm. There is a shloka in Gita also, this says the same, almost the same thing here. It's there, you know. Gyatva, knowing, Swahridam Sarva Bhutana, God, Ishvara, kya hai? God is friend of all. Friend? What kind of friend it is? Suhirdayam. Suhirdayam means the best possible friend of you, God is. You in your life search the best friend or not?
Yeah.
He is the best of all friends. He is after your heart also, after your choice also. It is according to your choice. Previous line, Bhoktaram Yajna Tapsam Sarva Loka Suhridam. Sarva Loka, not a friend of one, friend of all the people living in all the universes, you know. Friend of all. And Jyatva Shantim Richati. When the day you know him, peace, you know, flows out of you. You radiate peace. Here you are searching, there you will radiate. Rays of, you know, that peace will flow out of you. This is meditation. Because of meditation, thoughts change then, you know. But this is yoga also. Actually, the preacher says, you can know yourself only through Sankhya Yoga. Tatkaranam Sankhya Yoga, Yoga Adigamyam. Tatkaranam, that means neutral gender, because Brahma has got no sex, you know, is above sex. If you reach there, you can be above sex also. Before that, this is troubling us. We distinguish, this is women and I am man. You know? That wrong notion will go away. You are not neither man nor neither woman. You are what? You are Brahm. The power, the consciousness is one. No gender is there in it. Tat karanam. And it is the cause of everything. Mm-hmm. It can be known, or we can reach there by Sankhya or by Yoga. The Yoga we are teaching you. And so yoga is a practical of Sankhya, philosophy. How to realize that that's the aim of this sadhana, you know. The self in you is nothing but what? The same God, same Tat. Which is, because when actually you see, you are not attracted by man, you know. Man is not attracted by man. Man is attracted by women. Women is not attracted by women. In your life you see. But there when you go, this attraction will go. Your friend will be formed. Who can fulfill all your needs, all your desires, which are somewhere dormant, somewhere still there in your mind. They will be realized there, they will be experienced there. Those will be experienced there, you know. So this is the aim of yoga. Knowing nature and God and then reaching to the Supreme Spirit, which is everywhere in everybody and the friend of all. That's all. Because in the morning you have to go also. Yeah? Come on.
No, I want to ask Ron.
Yes, yes, no? Anybody can.
Ik kan maar klaar begrijpen, maar Ron is vertaald. Het is een verhaal, dus ik weet niet. Tot nu toe hebben we weinig begrepen.
Oké. Eigenlijk waar het op neerkomt in de hele meditatie, is op het moment dat wij in staat zijn om met onze aandacht naar binnen te keren en in die kruin te gaan zitten en boven die kruin uit te stijgen, dan eigenlijk pas komen we tot een punt waar we werkelijk kunnen zien van hoe de wereld, het universum in elkaar zit. Eigenlijk wat we tot nu toe hebben bedacht of denken te hebben bereikt, heeft alles te maken met de natuur, met de wereld buiten ons. En waardoor we eigenlijk een illusie hebben opgebouwd in onszelf van hoe wij denken dat de wereld in elkaar zit. Door de geschriften, door de boeken, door de praktijk kunnen we eigenlijk inzicht krijgen van hoe het zou kunnen zijn. En juist door de meditatie, juist door er bovenuit te stijgen, komen we eigenlijk in een gebied waarbij we in een licht komen, in een kennis komen wat universeel is en eigenlijk ook wel weer heel herkenbaar is. En dat is wat hij in het begin zei van, het is alsof we dat wisten, diep in ons zit dat, want dat is eigenlijk de bron ook waar wij uit voortkomen. Maar we zijn eigenlijk van het padje afgegaan, we hebben ons afgekeerd, we zijn in de schaduw gaan leven van dat licht. En doordat we in de schaduw van het licht zijn gaan leven, zijn we ons eigen wereldje gaan creëren. En juist door de meditatie draaien we ons eigenlijk weer om, naar het licht toe. En pas dan realiseren we ons wat we toen de tijd eigenlijk al wisten, maar wat we vergeten waren doordat we ons omgedraaid hebben, ons afgewend hebben. En in dat stukje zegt hij ook van, juist dat is het doel van die meditatie, dat is het doel van yoga. Om ons weer terug te laten draaien naar dat licht toe, waardoor we weer die eenheid voelen, die symbiose voelen, dat we eigenlijk een deel zijn van het geheel zijn, dat we niet gesplitst, afgescheiden zijn, maar dat we een deel daarvan zijn en dat we dat, die kennis ook in ons hebben al, alleen we hebben het bedekt. En juist door er bovenuit te stijgen, komen we in een onbegrensdheid. Wat ik vaker zeg met het subtiele lichaam, is onbegrensd. Juist op het moment dat we daar bovenuit stijgen, komen we ook in die kennisveld. Ik noem het even een kennisveld, maar dat is eigenlijk weet je daar. Is zien en weten gelijk. En dat zien is op een gegeven moment niet meer nieuw van, oh wat is dat? Nee, dat is, je weet het. En wat hij ook even op het laatst zei, moet ik even terughalen.
Het verschil tussen man en vrouw.
Oh ja, eigenlijk wat we wel eens zelf ook vaak zeiden al van, we zijn eerst een ziel, dan zijn we mens, dan zijn we man of vrouw. En op het moment dat we spiritualiteit, het pad van yoga opgaan, dan eigenlijk stijgen we daarin naar het sattvische beeld, dat we mens zijn, ziel zijn. Dat is wat wij moeten kunnen zien in elkaar. Maar op het moment dat we in een tamische, in het wereldse zitten, zullen we elkaar zien als man en vrouw in de vorm van een lustobject ook. Dat wij, als we de rajis zien, dan zien we het veel meer als ouders, de man en vrouw. En als we het sattvisch zien, dan zien we zielen. Wij zijn zielen, we zijn een deel uit dezelfde bron. En zeg van op het moment dat we daar bovenuit stijgen, boven die kruin uitstijgen, zitten we in dat niveau van die zielen. Dat we elkaar zien als gelijken. Pas op het moment dat we weer terugzakken, zien we weer dat we man en vrouw zijn. En dat Brahman eigenlijk, het goddelijke, eigenlijk seksloos is. Het is alles. Alleen in de vorm, in de laagste vorm van de natuur, zitten we de verschillen van seksen. En daar zit de man en vrouw. En dat is waar we dan ook eigenlijk zitten. Want als wij niet, als hier het licht straalt, hier zitten wij onder, dan zien we alleen vanuit die schaduw alles. We zien niet goed en zuiver. Eigenlijk wat we hier weten is eigenlijk niks. Maar dat we hier bovenuit strijden, dan gaan we zien van hoe het is. Dan gaan we die universele kennis ervaren en zien. Dat is kort staan.
Dat causatie heel
tussen. Ik niet. Op en aan.
Voordat je naar het lichaam zeg maar uit de universele, dan passeer je het causale gedeelte.
Nee. Je zit in het subtiele. Je stijgt boven het fysieke uit. En dan kom je in het subtiele, waar al veel meer ruimte is, onbegrensdheid is. En dan kom je, als je die samadhi hebt bereikt, dan kom je in dat causale waar de stabiliteit van intellect is.
Je hebt ooit over de samenheid
gehad.
Ja? Wat is dat dan?
Dat is het causale.
Maar je hebt twee dingen in dat causale toch?
Het samenheid, ja, zuivere denkstof.
Dat staat boven het.
Ja, zaligheidslichaam wordt het als geheel genoemd. Je hebt zuiver denkstof en zuiver bewustzijn. Dat is het prakriti en purush, wat daar in zit. Maar het wordt als zaligheidslichaam genoemd.
But citta is in essential also pure. Citta is in essential also pure. It's only when it becomes when it comes into our body, it will be activated, and then it will get all the impressions of previous lives. It will get surrounded, and therefore we see it as a shadow.
Actually, it is vacant, you know, without any sanskara. Citta has got no sanskara. Actually, that's why I said it is like what a mirror or a stone. If you put anything, it reflects that, you know.
Yeah.
What has happened, you know, because of the shadow, it is a shadow. False form of, you know, your is deluding you.
It's with false that, light, actually.
A false light and false knowledge also is there. Light is false, the knowledge is also false. Because of citta. Citta has three gunas. Those three gunas are manipulating your world. Mostly three gunas have three forms, tamaguna, you can't see first thing. But if you have, you know, intention to see, you won't try. If sometime it comes. Even if you have the capacity to reach here, even then you don't try. This is tamaguna. In Gita they said, you know, four qualities of, you know, sadhakas are there. And this is of those who are suffering in the world. Those who are suffering, they are like this, you know. They have their capacity, they have qualities in them, but because of their, you know, laziness, maybe physical or mental, they don't try at all. The next one is there. Sometimes he sees, but he says, I can't follow it. I hear, I understand, but I can't tread on this. I can't reach there. This is the second quality. And third is there. Sometimes good comes, sometimes bad comes. These are the three citta, you know, qualities of the citta, which is, you know, because of that, you know, false, we can say, shadow of those consciousness, three states of mind come in a suffering man. And suffering nobody likes. Then he tries what yoga is. Then only when sattvika comes in his mind. Sattvik, you know, vritti comes. But sattvik, you have to do everything sattvik, you know. Sattvik means which can lead you toward yourself. All actions, everything you take, through everything you hear, because in our, you know, scriptures, whatever you take, that is your food, whatever. Maybe through the eyes, maybe through the ears, maybe through the mouth, or through the skin, that is your food. That must be pure and assisting you, helping you in knowing what that reality is. Out of which that shadow is created in you. So this is, you know, yoga, citta, then vritti niroda. Vritti you know because it is false. So vritti is when you know they will merge back from where they have come. Citta contains all memories there, you know. So memories are created because of the vrittis, because of the changes which in you have come due to nature. Nature's instrument guide you, and with their influence, you do again what is creating ignorance, not creating knowledge. So when you go in and know the real self, then these things will go away, and then your real life, the real way of thinking, real way of acting, real way of doing, an objective which is to please God and which is in everybody, that will start. Peace will be in you, and we will share peace also. We will try to create peace in others also. That will be over, you know, way of living.
Ellen?
Nee,
nou, dat is allemaal weer. Chitta. Ja. Er is niet veel van. Of de chitta.
Sorry. Dat vroeg ik ook alweer. Maar dat alleen of de chitta in zichzelf puur is, zuiver.
Ja, ja. Chitta is zelf zuiver. Dat is eigenlijk wat we ook toen zeiden van die bol. Het is alleen de plek waar, zeg maar. Alleen heeft wel die kwaliteit, dat zijn de dina's. Het zit tamische, rajis en sattvies. Eigenlijk heeft hij wat uitgelegd over, weet je, wat is het typische gedrag, het kenmerk van iemand die tamisch is aangelegd. En het hele tamische gedrag heeft alles te maken met luiheid. Geen zin of geen idee, geen reden hebben om of maar iets wat te doen. Weet je, ja, elke inspanning, richting zit er niet. En het tweede vorm is veel meer.
En niet kunnen zien, hè? Ook niet kunnen.
Ja, niet kunnen zien. Bij die tweede, dat is bij die eerste. Ja. De tweede vorm heeft veel meer te maken met je kunt het wel zien. Je weet het ook wel, maar je komt er niet toe en je hebt het geen, je ziet geen reden om het te gaan doen.
Dat lukt me niet.
Nou, sterker nog, van we weten eigenlijk allemaal wat gezond leven is. Maar over daar echt naar leven, dat is het tweede. Dus je weet het wel, maar je doet het niet, je komt het niet. Op de een of andere manier laat je het. Weet je, we hebben nu allemaal geleerd van wat we moeten doen. En nu gaan we het natuurlijk gewoon hartstikke doen. Oh, toch komen we nu niet toe. Nou, de tweede vorm is dus een beetje een herkenbare vorm. En bij de derde is veel meer de gretigheid aanwezig. Ofwel van... Bij die derde vorm weet je eigenlijk ook niet vaak te kiezen. Dat is het probleem met die derde vorm. Je weet niet te kiezen van welke, wat ga ik doen, welk pad ga ik op. Terwijl je wel de dingen weet, maar je, weet je, je maakt die laatste stap niet bij. Je gaat niet voor die eenpuntigheid. Het is diversiteit die nog steeds je interesse heeft. Dus dat zijn die vormen waar we als mens zeg maar in zitten. En de guna's kunnen ons helpen om daar bovenuit te stijgen. Dus als we naar het sattvische gaan, dat laten prevaleren, dan hebben we veel meer mogelijkheid om naar die eenpuntigheid te komen. Om dan weer tot dat punt te komen wat ik net op plaats zei van, dat je werkelijk dan inzage krijgt, inzicht krijgt van wat het leven inhoudt, hoe we ons zouden moeten gedragen en wat we zouden kunnen doen in het leven waarvoor we hier zijn.
Maar je hebt toch weer drie kwaliteiten en drie guna's.
Ja.
Dat doe je, toch? Ja.
Can I ask you, Guruji, something about the ode that we did tonight?
Yeah.
Ron told us this afternoon that you can use ode for several uses. At a certain moment, we heard you were doing... And I do as you do, so I did it as well. But what was the use of it? I could feel how always lifting up.
Actually, what happens, you know, when you empty your lungs by uttering any sound, they are emptied. The more you, you know, longer and with force, Om is pronounced, lungs get empty. The empty lungs means their tension, and usually they are always full of air. And you have seen balloons which are full of air all the time. When air is no more, what is their position?
No.
They have lost their elasticity which they possess. In the same way, the power in the lungs is lost. They are always full. With this, they are, you know, vacated to the maximum. With you, you have to, you know, somebody, you know, keep the rhythm. I do it little, you know, faster. Then we have to breathe in, you know, up to the bottom of the body. It goes to the anus, it hits there. When I take it, it hits at the anus. And there is the, you know, way of Sushumna, the door of Sushumna, through which it enters into the brain again.
I don't understand this last word.
Last word, that to be understood, you know.
Sushumna.
Sushumna.
In the Sushumna.
Sushumna.
In the Ida Pingala, Sushumna, Khauta Canal. Yeah, it's not in the syllables.
Yeah, you can lezen.
En daar gaat de ademhaling.
Als je diep uitademt, echt je longen helemaal leeg maakt, dan moet je weer opnieuw. Dus hij zegt van, op het moment dat je die beweging zoals hij net maakte, is het dat je langs die wervelkolom de hele lijn dus steeds kunt oprekken, maar dat die energie daar ook langs gaat. Sushumna is de grote nadi in je rug, van alle nadis. En de Ida en Pingala, die krullen daar omheen.
They move like this, you know. En central one is Sushumna, you have seen in the chart. You know, something. Yeah. But it is having a little thin, you know, we can say, covering over the mouth. And when we did this pranayama, it's then broken, you know. With the heat created by pranayama. There. Then the prana goes up here. With that, the energy also goes. Other day, I said, a serpent like, you know, energy goes here. It was like this, then it becomes like this, you know. Here, sometimes we see it. Oh, here it is now, prana. So these are the use of the doing, you know. Because
als je de Ida en de Pingala en de Sushumna komen bij je Anya chakra samen, en van daaruit gaat het als één stroom naar je Brahma chakra. Dat is waarom je zegt van, hier kun je het op een gegeven moment voelen, dat die energie zeg maar omhoog komt, die kracht omhoog komt. Je zegt van onderin de wervelkolom, is die kundalini. Is dat op het moment dat je door dit soort ademhalingsvormen zeg maar die kracht daar kunt ontwikkelen, dan kun je zeg maar op een gegeven moment dat stukje energie wakker maken waardoor het omhoog komt naar je Brahma chakra. Maar dat gaat eerst via je en je chakra.
Wat gebeurt er dan vanaf daar? Hoe gaat die dan weer omhoog? Zijn
hier komen die drie rivieren bij elkaar.
Ja.
Hier komen ze bij elkaar.
Mm-hmm.
Hier gaat als één rivier omhoog naar je Brahma chakra.
Yeah.
If you chant Om, is it okay to put your tongue against the lalana chakra?
Well, lalana is in the throat, you know, it could be the same. Because lalana is in the throat, from where the entrance to this, you know, Ajna chakra is there. Ajna chakra. So, from there, prana goes in, you know. Usually, you know, there was a tradition in Hatha Yoga. They used to, you know, lengthen the tongue by, you know, milking it. And then they used to, you know, cough that hole with that tongue. Their tongue becomes lengthy, you know. You won't reach here, your tongue won't reach here. So they can, you know, cough down that hole so that after prana, yama, when prana goes there, it may not come back. That is, was there. And in that, later on, what happened? A sweet, sweet something comes from inside also. A drop is sufficient for all the day. You don't need that, anything then.
The nectar, you mean?
Yes, nectar. It's nectar.
Yeah. Is nectar coming from the window?
Oh, from Brahman Chakra, from that is there.
Het helpt je in je focus.
Ja.
Sowieso.
Maar Vedananda zei het toch niet vrij zijn?
Ja,
dat
zei het.
Vrij of zwaar moest zijn. Dat je niks meer zo
aan. When you do the oath, it was said by Swamiji Vedananda that the tongue should not touch anything in your mouth.
It should be free.
It should be free. So you should not put your tongue, for instance, to the
What is happening, you know? You can't utter a word without touching some point. Ta, ta, where the tongue is going. Ta, it will touch the T. Hana.
Mm-hmm.
A, O, A.
Okay.
It is not touching. But U, it is not touching.
No.
Ma, not touching.
No.
Tongue is not touching here.
Nothing.
Not. A, A. A U M is arm, home.
Oh, yeah.
A U, where it is touching? Mom, not touching.
But so the question was, can you, even if you don't have to use it, can you even then put your tongue against the palate?
That's another thing, you know. You are getting another benefit out of that. If you turn your tongue to with a palate, one objective is. Sometimes we are out of practice, previous, you know, practice habit, we can say, tongue can move, first thing. It will not shake with pronouncing om. One is this. When it is with the palate, what happens? That naturally your, you know, first attention will be where it is touching. That there it will go for some time. And later on what happens? It helps you to balance the prana. Pranayama.
Just concentration.
Yes, then it. Because movements, you can stop thought, but breath is there. Mm-hmm. A stage will come that breath will also stop. Then concentration will be complete.
Mm-hmm. Crystal clear. Glas helder.
Hala. Hala. Hello.
Thank you.
Welcome. Try your best. Try your best. Break your duty. Your gifts, which are due to your imagination. You need something better. A better state of mind. Better result. Better intelligence. That's one, later on you got
the
later on, it will be alright, because it was after many days you are going there. How many years? Probably 8 years now. Once you went to him, you went to that
scene.
After 8 years, went there.
So that's
normal. Yes. Later it will become normal.
Do you think you
need to stay
here tomorrow and
do that? Because it's pretty, it's not bad. But here, you know, the mind is, you know, love for these things must remain and going, moving, but yeah, it must be there very difficult. Are they there? How are you? Bad?
If you have a bad meditation,
it can't be bad if you did it, you
know. In the morning,
I'm going to go to the next one.